Here comes a bridge. So here it is, this is it. 2003 Chevy SSR. It's not a particularly high performance motor. It's decent, it's got good power, but it's not like it makes 500 horsepower. But it sounds like it makes 500 horsepower. The exhaust system on it, I'll show it in a second. I'm not sure if it's stock or not. It looks really stock, it looks correct. But I mean, it just sounds too good to be stock. It's amazing. Absolutely great little truck. So this one here is obviously red with a black interior. It's really nice. It's unique in the sense that, I'm gonna use the word unique a lot. It's just, it's a unique truck, okay? Bear with me. they made a decent amount of these, not enough that you'd see one every day. But I mean, every city has a couple of them, which is cool. The interior, it's typical early 2000 Chevy. A lot of plastic. There's no actual leather. It's all formed plastic. What's something you don't usually see is that the interior has body painted colored finish everywhere, you know? So there's a lot of, as you can see, body color red all over the place. I'm gonna pull in and we'll put the top on. Yeah, it's a convertible truck, right? How nuts is that? Not something you see ever. As I was discussing with my neighbors, is I don't know who designed this truck, but man, I'm amazed that they got the freedom to be able to do what they wanted to do, which is a convertible truck, you know? Let me go back a hair. Like, who is this truck built for, you know? It's a very unique customer, to say the least. I'm glad they did it. It's got a really quick automatic top. I say quick, but it's quick enough. 10, 15 seconds. But yeah, it's hard to say like who this truck was built for. What I mean by that is like, a lot of the times when a company is gonna design a new vehicle, they wanna say, okay, here's our target audience. They'll say to themselves, we wanna build a small, affordable SUV for young couples, or for, there's a Lexus NX, I think 300, 350. That vehicle was built specifically for the young, up and coming, professional woman. Sounds very specific, but yeah, if you look through all the literature, they specifically say that's who they want to buy that SUV. That being said, I cannot seem to figure out for the life of me who they're building this truck for. Because you're thinking, okay, they're building this truck for truck people. While truck people don't want, typically, they don't want a $50,000 two-door vehicle that has a very low towing capacity and a bed that's not able to carry stuff. I'll show you the bed. I'll probably put a clip right here. The bed, it has wood trim with carpet, and then it has carrying cases on the side. My point is you can't even fit a piece of plywood in it. So they didn't build it for truck people because that's not what a truck guy wants to use. So you're thinking, okay, well, it's got a V8. It's rear wheel drive. Maybe they bought it for the, they built it for the sports people, sports cars. Okay, great. That's possible, but you're gonna spend $50,000 on a V8 that's rear wheel drive in the early 2000s, you got a lot of options. I mean, of course you got the GT Mustang, you have the Catfish Camaro, but there's not a lot of overlap. I believe the last year of the Catfish was 2002. This truck was debuted in 2002, 2003. Once again, 50 grand can get you a very, very nice Catfish Camaro brand new with more power. So if you're a sports guy, you're gonna get the Catfish. Or you might, like I mentioned, go for a Mustang, or if you reach for the sky, an extra 10 grand will get you a Viper. So it's not the sports person, the sports car per se. Okay, well, it's a convertible, so maybe it's going to be for the everyday cruiser kind of person. Great. Once again, there's a lot of convertibles that are available for a lot less than 50 grand in the early 2000s. So, like I mentioned, it's a bit of a hodgepodge. I'm extremely happy that GM gave the thumbs up and let them create this. Oh, the Corvette. A Corvette in the early 2000s was probably 40, 50 grand, and that's a V8 rear-wheel drive manual target top car. And that's why, I think that's also why I didn't have a long production run, because it was asking a lot of money for a car that, it's kind of like, it's the master of none, but a jack of all trades at the same time. Which I'm realizing now, the person this is built for is the car enthusiast. Which is strange, because you normally wouldn't think about the car enthusiast, but that's who it's built for, man. That's the only crazy person that would spend that kind of money on a vehicle like this, that is not good at being a car, it's only got two seats, it's not good at being a truck, you can't tow in it, and it's convertible. So that's what I'm glad they built it. That's who it is. I just realized it's for the car enthusiast, and that's who I am. This one was purchased by my dad recently. He went out and bought it. He's never even mentioned an SSR, which is the funny part. He just saw it, he knew what it was, test drove it once or twice and said he likes it, so he picked it up. This particular example, it has 17,800 miles. 17,800 miles, which is insane. So being an early 2000s GM, you do get a lot of plastic, a lot of, you know, a lot of stuff you'd expect to see from back in the day. You get your tachometer, miles per hour. So here there is no shift indicator. You don't get the park, reverse, neutral, drive. But they do provide it for you there. You may not be able to see it with their LEDs, they're blinking so. But yeah, that's what that is. It's now, you'll notice they're very clean doors. There's no buttons, there's no lock, unlock, window up, window down. All you get is a lock indicator back here. I'll show you on my side. And then on the driver's side, all you get is your mirror adjustments. Here's the fun part. Here's your center control. So of course, a window up, window down, both sides. Door lock, unlock, traction control. Which I know why it's there. It's there because there's no other buttons related to the car. So that's just a good place for it. And then of course your top actuation for up and down. What's been pointed out by others, which is really interesting, is that all these buttons are the exact same size and they have the exact same feel. None of them are textured. None of them have Braille. I say Braille, not because a blind person is driving. I mean that if you're touching it while having your eyes on the road, like you're supposed to be, a little bit of texture dots, one dot, two dot, three dots would have been very helpful, so you can know what you're pushing and now you don't accidentally, like, you know, toggle your traction control. If you're an old person that doesn't expect to have traction control turned off while you're trying to roll down your window, or maybe you're trying to lock the doors, you're pushing buttons and then, you know, small oversight, not the end of the world. Standard AC controls, all that's normal. They all fully function, of course, which is great. And then, like I mentioned, the piece de resistance is that you do have interior plastic, which is painted to the body color. And it wraps around all the way to the back. And then, I mean, in reality, it continues because from that wrap around, it then just blends into the hard top. This is the coolest thing. I haven't really seen one of these in a while, where it's an interior painted piece of plastic like this. Corvette kind of had something like it, but not really, just somewhat similar. Yeah, and then it all goes seamlessly into the back. Tonneau cover is what they call it. It does have these, which indicates it's kind of like a roll bar. But I'm willing to bet it's probably just for aesthetics. I doubt it's actually a roll bar. If this thing rolls, I know that these are always built to... The A-pillar will hold you up.
But I don't have a lot of faith that these would actually do anything. Plus, I just realized I'm taller than it. So if it rolled, my head would still make contact. But I mean, you know, just don't roll it. How about that? Don't flip the truck and you'll be fine.
Went away.
Okay, so we're good. I can pull out?
Yep.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yeah, this is called a Chevy SSR. It's a convertible truck.
I'm actually surprised how very clean it is. I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah. The guy who had it, my dad also, he had some guy polish it.
Didn't he say he had a 14,000 miles on it?
17,000 miles.
That
yeah.
is insane.
It's like a 2003, I think. 2002 or 3, I'll double check.
Fuck, it's old as me.
Shit. That's a good point. Dude. It's old as me. I forgot.
There's some miles on me, but not this.
You might have 17,000 miles on you. Well, track days. Yeah, it's super dude. Nuts. Yeah, the guy who had it just took very good care of it. And I was mentioning that what's so nuts is that I've only seen one other SSR, right? Mm. And when I saw it, I lived in my old house next to the, I lived next to my old house and I'd only seen a red SSR that parked like four or five houses up. Randomly, he would show up, you know? And I was talking to the guy that sold us this truck and I mentioned that. I was like, yeah, I've only ever seen one other one and it was one that lived, parked up the street from my house, blah, blah. Yeah. And the guy mentions the elementary school. He's like, was it that school? And I was like, yeah. And he's like, that was this truck.
Oh, shit.
And I was like, what do you mean? That was this truck. No way. And he's like, yeah, that was my girlfriend's house. And I would go stay over for a couple of days. Like, because he's an old man, you know? Yeah. And I was like, what? And so that was in 2000, like, 3, 4, 5, when I was going to elementary school, dude. What are the odds? Yeah. That is this exact truck. Yeah, so I was like, holy
shit. Small little world, huh?
Small world, man.
Now, what's cool is that Chevy did put a bunch of SSR badges everywhere. These are the ones that I was able to find. I'm sure there's probably one or two more, but here's a couple of photos. I mean, they put this thing every single place that they could. So, carpets in the glass, on the dash, a little bit of everywhere, but surprisingly not on the dash itself.
If you get the opportunity to drive one of these to enjoy it for a day, even a couple of hours, do it. Take it around the block, turn on the radio, jam out to your favorite tunes. You're gonna love it. You're gonna thank yourself, man. These are cool.
It needs some TLC, a little bit of that, whatever that squeaky belt thing is, pulleys, brakes, tires. But it's beautiful, runs and drives. Great little option. See you guys.